Hi guys, welcome back. So today's video is actually going to have two intros, so I'm going to make this quick. I just wanted to get on here and just say a big thank you. So 2 days ago I hit over 1k, and 1,000 subscribers is like a spit in the ocean in this YouTube world, but it really does mean everything to me. So I just wanted to come on here and say thank you. I had no idea that my recent Fenty video would get so many views and so much love. So I just wanted to get on here and just say thank you guys. Thank you so much. I know that this is just the beginning and I just can't wait to see like where everything goes from here. And all of you guys' sweet, sweet comments, they really do mean so much to me. You guys have no idea. It's so cool to know that people who are perfect strangers can be so loving and kind. And now is a better time than any to ask you guys what you want to see. So please let me know down below what kinds of videos you want to see, what do you want me to do next, all that good stuff. So just thank you, thank you, thank you. I love you guys so much. And yeah, let's get right into the Tatcha review. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So in this video today, I'm gonna be showing you my mini review on the Tatcha Silk Canvas Primer. So this primer I have been trying to get my hands on for a while, but it has been sold out like left and right, both online and in stores near me. Finally, I got my hands on it. So today I'm gonna be doing a quick review and just pretty much a comparison against one of my favorite primers, the YSL Blurring Primer. So if you guys wanna see my take on this primer, then just keep on watching. All right, so this is how the primer comes. So it comes in this box right here. So actually right in the flap, once you open the box, it actually says beautiful faces, beautiful futures. It says one purchase equals one day of school. So that's super cute. So already I do see the little chip thing that you use to scoop out the primer. Just reading like the instructions and everything, I know that that little line there is where you pretty much put the primer. So out of the box, it comes in like a wrapping. Okay. Okay. So definitely nice and heavy. So that is what it looks like. It's just this very light pink kind of balmy primer. So I'm only gonna put this on one side of my face, and I'm gonna put my YSL Touche Clot Blur Primer on the other side, just because I know that this is like a smoothing, blurring type of primer, so I just wanna see how they compare. So I just got this amount out. Well, I guess that would be enough for like one face, but we're just putting it on this side. So something that's pretty cool that I read while I was looking through the pamphlet that it comes with is that it is inspired by an ingredient that I cannot pronounce. Okay, so it's inspired by a wax-based primer called Bintsuki. I know I said that wrong. Apparently that is something that geisha women would put on their skin before they applied their traditional white makeup. So eager to see how this turns out. All right, and now I'm just gonna quickly put the YSL primer on the other side. I'm actually about to go to work, so I really hope that it's not like a drastic difference once I put my foundation on. So yeah. So I don't know if you guys can tell the difference, but this is the YSL side over here. And I mean, I love this primer. It definitely, it always does what I need it to do. And it doesn't have any color at all. I mean, it has like little like flecks of glitter in it, but it like barely shows up on the skin anyway. But I like a glow, so I don't care. But on this side, there's definitely like a cast of white, which I've seen like, you know, when people are applying it anyway. It definitely has like a cast to it. I'm not gonna lie, like I don't love the way this looks like right now. Like I just look ashy, but I mean, you know, I don't care about that because foundation's gonna go over top anyway. But just like initially, I'm just looking like, ew. But anyways, I'm just gonna quickly do my makeup off camera and I will be right back to show you what it looks like. Let's get close. So this is the YSL side and then this is the Tatcha. I don't know if you guys could tell with my other videos, but like my camera has a built-in feature that kind of like softens the skin. So I don't even know if this is going to show what the primer actually looks like on both sides even, because it's just gonna try to like smooth my skin. So yeah, I could definitely tell a difference with the Tatcha side. Yeah, it definitely smooths my skin. On the Tatcha side, it definitely looks, it's kind of a big difference. I'm like looking back and forth like, wow. I mean, my pores aren't that bad, but they're like non-existent over here. So that's good. I really like this primer a lot so far. My foundation went over it really well. Like it looks smooth. It looks really good. Skin looks good for as like textured as it is right now. There's really nothing else that I would compare this primer to. I'm trying to think of one that I have or I've used, but I don't know. I really can't compare like the actual consistency of the primer. I thought it'd be a lot thicker than it is, but it's not. But it's okay because I actually like the feeling that it gives. Like it's, I don't know. But I do like the way that it feels. And the white cast obviously is completely gone. But I'm liking it. So for some people who use this, they said that it gives like more coverage to whatever foundation that you're using. I don't really see that. Yeah, I mean on both sides they really do look the same. I would say that maybe the foundation kind of adhered to this side really, really well. But I mean, it looks the same like all over my face, so I don't know yet. I don't know. I guess I have the same reaction like everyone else did. Like, it's like you don't know if you love it, like at first. I do know that my pores are blurred. Like, that is for sure. Like, this whole, like, area here is, like, flawless. Yeah, I really like the way that it looks, though. It's definitely, it's pretty. And this side is kind of, like, my worst side as far as texture goes. So, I think it did a It did a pretty good job, for sure, with like blurring my skin as much as possible. So I do like it for that. I think I'm really just going to keep testing this out just to see like if I really, really, really like it. Because yeah, this is pricey. This is pretty pricey. And I mean, you guys know I don't mind spending. Like, I have a lot of luxury makeup items, but that's because I really believe in the actual products. Like, they actually make a difference and look beautiful. But for this one, if it's, you know, if it just is a little bit more smoothing than my other primers that I really love, then I don't know if that's enough to justify this price. But we will see. I will continue to wear this. But I mean, for now, I think it looks really pretty. I think I do need to try it like all over my face instead of next to this primer. So yeah, I think I'm gonna do that. So that is it for this video. I hope it was helpful. If you enjoyed it, please be sure to give it a thumbs up. Subscribe if you're not, and check out my other videos while you're here. Thank you guys so much for watching and I'll see you on the next one. Bye guys. Dad talking so loud.